Well, hello people, hi. We are back again over here at Gclicks Studios along with Goenkar. And today we are going to again talk about coal because the Goa and Goenkar Sonaka movement is doing the rounds. And in regards to this, we met a very interesting person, John Coutinho. Well, John Coutinho is the founder member of Goenkar, and he's also a curator. He is a person who brings in people together to spread awareness regarding different environmental issues. So let's go straight to his house and check out what he has to say in regards to coal.
From, I don't know, in my lifetime I was part of the opinion poll, but I was small. Then came the language agitation, then came the statehood agitation. We got both of them together, but I was very much part of those two. Then came the regional plan. Then came CZMP. And all these issues, the government brings it to us and we have to fight them because they are wrong. Then they backtrack, they do or something or maybe give you something. But this, what is happening now, has never happened in, and there is no precedent to the size of the thing that is going to happen now. The size is in the terms of the quantity of coal that is going to come to Goa and make a Goa the hub is, I don't know, we will never see the Goa that we saw. Our children are not going to see it if this happens. And this is why we have come and fighting. And I'm getting tired. There are boys in my age that are getting tired of the same fights that we have to do, every issue that we have to fight. We're getting tired. And this is maybe the government what is banking on, to have the fatigue in people not to take it forward. But let it be a very clear message to the government. You go ahead with this. You are not on another planet. Your children are not on another planet. There is no plan B. This is now happening to you. Whatever is going to happen to us is going to happen to your children too. There is no plan B. There is no another planet. Our union minister makes a statement of saying, environmentally, if you cut trees, it will take 50 to 60 years and then you will have the environment again. Right now where the world is, we do not have the luxury of 50 to 60 years. And it's just mind-boggling to see our union minister making a statement like this. Our environment minister says, yes, there's going to be some destruction of the environment, but we need the power. And other people not enjoying the power. Yes, given you're enjoying the power, but have you thought of any alternative, any cleaner energy to give to the people? Yes, we are purchasing the power. Is there any way that you have done studies to see at the solar? We are in the tropical place and you are telling us that we are not suitable for solar energy. We are in the coastal belt of 104 kilometers. You are telling us there is no possibility of wind energy, wave energy, nothing. And that we have to just cut the trees for the sake of development. Is that the development we are talking about just now? Without thinking, for a plant to grow into a tree, it will take about 20 to 30 years. We do not have this luxury. The only way you can bring the climate down is a tree. It's not rocket science. That day, the power minister says, we are part of India, that's why we have to help the country in the developing, and that's why we have to sacrifice now with the coal to give them the power, and the power also to bring back to the state. Yes, we are part of India, and that's why we have to do such a thing. But India is not separate from the rest of the world. The climate change that is happening in the world is the same world. We do not have this luxury. Everybody else knows, except that India goes, our Prime Minister is a signatory. India is a signatory to all the climate change accords that are signed. That by certain time, we will bring our energy, fossil fuel consumption lower, everything that he goes and makes the sound. But when he comes back to the nation, it does it differently. And then, the records are there, to pass this project, he circumvented all his own laws to make it fast track. The checks and balances that were done by the previous government, I'm not saying the previous government was good, but there were checks and balances for this, for environment or anything else. They have circumvented by making the project smaller, where you don't need the IEA and all these things. Now, there are experts that will give you all these things, but the logic is, if you are sacrificing the climate and the environment to show development, it is a foolish decision. if you don't have the development that we require because of the destruction, maybe we should not have the development. I'm not talking about only the roads and the power and the thing. But here you are right now, you're bringing coal to a state that is the smallest state in the union, 140 kilometers by 90 kilometers, and you're trying to make the state a coal hub, that you bring the coal from Australia, from Indonesia and South Africa. And from here, last year, they brought 12 million tons. Now the projection is for 51 million tons, and then later on the projection is 136 million tons, which they never wanted to tell us anyway. This we found out only to RTIs and their projection. These projections are not what we are projecting. This is the government's project, the shipping ministry. Now if this happens, where they now never told us this nationalization of river was for what? But when you connect the dots, then you see, there's no other cargo that we are going to have in Goa, except for the coal. Now how much land is already there with the union? Whether you are taking the railways, whether you are taking the navy or the army, or who else? Now Mopa is gone. It is not for us. It is not going to be another Las Vegas. Now you are saying nationalization of rivers. The recent one, which is going to be the nailed in the coffin, is the ports bill that is just recently done. Now if you look at it by details, they are saying ports bills. Now, and also there was a very recent statement that said that they will allow private fishing jetties on the rivers. Now these fishing jetties themselves will be called ports. And if you look at that ports bill, it says the government doesn't, the local authorities do not have any say into what they want to do in those port bills. They can build a building, they can do anything that they want, they can acquire land, they can do anything. And nobody has said anything about it, it's passed. Nobody has said anything about this port bill. Even the opposition has not passed. Here, they finished the opposition by buying the 10 MLAs. There's no opposition. The five guys that are there and the three other guys and the independent are not saying anything. The logic behind this is because very clear. Goa has only 40 MLAs. Now, if you were thinking of taking it to Karnataka or something, there are more than 250 MLAs. Now, you have to buy, what is cheaper, to buy the 40 MLAs or the 250 MLAs? This is cheaper. They can buy all the guys and finish it. Some of the guys might not like it, but I don't know. This is not, I'm just making an assumption that they must have been paid. But otherwise, where is the noise? Where is the noise? Even if there's a lone voice that is fighting, where is he? Even the assembly was not done, a one-day assembly session was done. And all the paper parties agreed to have this one-day assembly session. They should have said, no, we want to talk to you about this issue. And not allowed it. They should have said, no, we can take the precaution for the COVID and still discuss these issues. You have the machinery to take the precautions and do it. You took the COVID issues and not doing it, and there was no discussion. But they passed the bills. Nobody stopped passing those bills. This is a loud and clear call from Mother Goa to come out and fight. This is the time. In another 5 years or no, there's no more fight. It's too late. Later on, when this thing, expansions keep on happening, they might tell you now. Well, who's told you about 10, like example for Shandar? They want to make it a coal hub, but nobody is talking about the 10 rails that will come as parking rails, or that it's going to be a coal hub, that the river is going to be brought, is going to be brought here, but nobody's talking to you about it. So they'll say double track. And then they'll say, why are you objecting to a double track? That might be useful for us. So you keep quiet. They will fence the area that they want now, and that is the railway properties. Then the question comes, what I'm doing in my property is my business, not your business. I can put 10 rail of this. Nobody will be able to fight it at that time. Too late. So now, people that are really sometimes going things, why should I make a noise or somebody else will fight about it? This is the time to come out and fight. Otherwise, it will be too late. Even there won't be another issue that is more important than the issue. Even Congress was surprising. The president of Congress says to us, first he showed that when we showed him the presentation, says, yes, it's surprising. Next day, 2 days later, we go and he says, I knew all about this. And when we asked him, why did you not tell the people if you knew this? He says, you all think this is an important issue. There are more important issues than this. And I told him, tell me one issue that is more important than this. He says, to you this is important. To a guy and to another people, they come per day two or three issues. But if we have people like this that are in the opposition or the party heads that are telling us this, there is no hope that somebody else is going to fight. So that means it is left to the people to fight. There is no other choice. The people have to come, and there are precedents set. People have won. Even when the government decides, the people, if they don't decide not to have it, they will win. People's power wins ultimately. But the only way people's power wins, not by 200 or 300 people gathering for a meeting. It has to be people coming out on the street and do replicate what we did for the language agitation. My last words to you all is, please, this is the time to come out, fight whatever way you can. Maybe it is just by giving a donation, or maybe it is coming on the street, maybe it's helping in giving the pamphlets or anything. But be part of this fight. And we have done this, in our village. We have gone to house, and people who could not even afford a proper meal had given us 10 rupees generously to be part of this fight. And if you think, okay, my lifespan is finished, I'm already 60 or I'm 67 or whatever, do this for the next generation. And they will thank you for this, because, and even if you fail, God forbid, but even if you fail, you will be proudly be able to say to your next generation, we fought for you, we tried, and we failed. And with this, thank you for listening to my rant. Thank you.
Well, well, well. Well, apparently the man had some valid points, I guess. Well, as you can see, I'm wearing this t-shirt over here, Goa and Goenkar. So again, it's in regards to we don't need coal in Goa. So do subscribe to our channel and do join the movement. We are coming up with a lot of more activities. We are coming up with a lot of more awareness videos. So please, please, please stay tuned. Thank you.